Hello, Dr. Vicki Peterson here. As you can see, I have a little friend with me today. This is Lola. And the reason Lola is with us today is really to make a point about root cause medicine and why we practice root cause medicine on humans. We're not vets, but you'll see my point in a minute. So Lola is my dog, and I was on vacation with my husband for a couple of weeks. And we came back, and about 5 days later, Lola started sneezing. If you have a small dog, she not only was sneezing, but she was reverse sneezing. So small dog owners seem to know what this is, but it's this weird kind of, I don't know, snorting sound that they make that's a little disconcerting if you've never heard it before. And she started doing that and sneezing, and so needless to say, I brought her to the vet. So when I got to the vet, I wasn't given a lot of information. So I went a few days ago, and they basically said maybe she has a cold, maybe she has allergies, she might have inhaled what's called a foxtail. Those are those little, once again, if you're not a dog owner, you might not be familiar, but these little tiny round things that have spikes around them, and maybe dogs sometimes get them in their feet, but they can also inhale them and it can be really dangerous. So she didn't think it was that, although she wasn't highly confident. And so I kind of left with not a lot of information. She offered an antibiotic, she offered an antihistamine, and you know, which are very different things. And that was about it. So I said, you know, we were gone for a couple of weeks and she did lose a little bit of weight. So we confirmed that. She went from a whole 6.5 pounds down to 6 pounds. But a half a pound is kind of a big deal when you only weigh 6 pounds. So anyway, we decided we were gonna watch it. So another 2 days goes by to this morning, and she was really sneezing and doing that horrible reverse sneezing thing, even more so. So I decided to bring her in because I really didn't feel like I had a diagnosis. So I saw a different vet, as luck would have it, and she did a much more thorough exam, so that was interesting. So if you're going to be a good diagnostician, you definitely have to use your diagnostic skills. So she did a much more thorough exam and said that Lola absolutely did not have an infection. She did not have a fever. Her lungs were clear, so not to worry about that. She said she definitely had not inhaled a foxtail. She said the sneezing doesn't stop, and for her, as you can see, she's not sneezing at all, right now. But for her, the sneezing is after she's been at rest. She's been sleeping for a while, and then she's sneezing. So she said it wasn't a foxtail and it wasn't an infection, and most likely it was allergies. So it's like, okay, good. We're honing in on it. And she offered that an antihistamine. So apparently Benadryl, which is a human antihistamine, is good for dogs as well. So she said she recommended doing that. As you know, I'm not big on drugs, so I asked what other options were available, and she said, well, actually just giving her a bath and actually bathing her face and paws every night to get the pollen off. Apparently, at least right now here in the Northern California area, pollen is very high and there's a lot of dogs that are pretty miserable with allergies. So then I asked the next question. Being a doctor, it's easy for me because I think that way. So how often, you know, how effective are antihistamines? She said, oh, not very. About 10% of the time they work. So that would have been nice to have heard at the beginning, right? So, you know, it's interesting. So here, I was just sort of living this from the viewpoint of a person going to the doctor, because of course I'm fortunate, and personally, you know, obviously I handle things myself here at the clinic and my family. But you know, you've had that experience of going to the doctor more than one time, right, for the same problem, and then maybe getting different answers or better answers, hopefully better answers, but sometimes frustratingly just different answers and not very helpful answers. And ultimately, although it was great to know she doesn't have an infection and she doesn't have a foxtail, when it came to the allergies, what I was recommended to do for her was something that was effective 10% of the time. So, you know, not a great recommendation, right? So if you came into my clinic with allergies and you had never had them before, you know, I'd immediately start looking at stressors. So what was the stressor? Mommy was gone for 2 weeks, and didn't eat as well around other dogs, and you know, who knows what kind of environment that was, although the groomer and border is very good. But you know, definitely out of her routine for 2 weeks, did lose weight, and you know, this was a stress to her system, and then you add a high pollen count, and then you start getting to the root cause of it. So obviously she's home now, she's gaining weight, she's eating well, and you know, all should be fine. So the point is here, the point I'm trying to make, is that root cause medicine does just that. It gets to the underlying root cause of why your symptoms are there. Not masking them, not giving you some temporary fix that's only going to last very temporarily, but really figuring out, based on how the body functions, why you have the symptom. Why is your body giving you that symptom? What does it mean? How to really get to the root cause of it to optimize your health. So I thought it was just a fun little example of how we think, why we think the way we think, and how it can happen in more than just humans. It can happen in other animals, and how it's really not that different. You know, you really need to think that way with your pet, and for sure you need to think that way about your body and your children's and family's bodies as well. So if you are at all frustrated with any symptoms that you're continuing to have and you feel like you're not really getting to the root cause, let me know and I'll see what I can do to help you. That's why I'm here. And until next time, Lola and I wish you very good health.